Ready for a Zohar? This is going back to the Garden of Eden, the beginning of time, as we discuss it. And we're talking about a woman. The woman saw that the tree is good to be eaten. It's lustful to the eyes. There was an attraction to this tree. So it says like this, Tochazi, come and see. The hub ne noshalem is taklin. People don't look. Vilayodin, they don't know. Vilemashgichin, and they're not paying attention. Bishat de barakitch brichil adam at the time that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created man. Vokele bi kiri lo and he made him more dear and more precious with a lofty preciousness, meaning that he raised them above everybody else. Boy Minele is Dapkobe, he asked man, please connect with me. Why? Begin the Ishtakach Yechidoi, that man should be united. Man should be one. Man should know his source, he should know his power. Ibeliba Yechidoi, he should have one heart, he should have a united heart. He should be attached to a place of unity that never changes. The knot of unity, that everything in the world is tied to it. That's called the tree of life. What's the tree of life? The unity that exists within all of creation. Who created all of creation? One unity. If you tap into that recognition, to that realization, you're attaching yourself to the tree of life. The tree of life is the tree that gives you life. When you imagine yourself separate from that, when you imagine yourself an individual, you've separated yourself from that tree. You've separated yourself from your source of power. Your legitimacy doesn't come from what you think or what you're capable of or what you've learned. Your legitimacy comes from your attachment to the one who gave you life. He is the authority and he gives life. When you recognize that, you gain access to his power, his authority. So when you do things that you understand are good for life, you're working together with the unity, together with the source. The basar after that, satu me'ocha de me'emnusa, they went away, they went off the path of the proper belief. V'shafku ilona yechido ilo, they left this tree of unity, mikol ilonim. They started thinking in a way that's constantly changing. They started judging. They started looking at things and deciding with their mind, with their authority, is it good or is it not good? Do I like it or don't I like it? Instead of being attached to the source of life and knowing that he created and therefore it's good and now I have to live that, they started coming towards the creator, towards creation, with conflict. Let's see what he created. Does it work for me? Does it not work for me? How do I protect myself from him? From who? From the one that created you? You want to protect yourself from the one that created you? Does that seem logical? And so once they started thinking in that format, they started interpreting things as good to them, not good to them. They like it or they don't like it. So now they're going into a place, they're going into a mindset that contains good and evil. Now they're judging. Now things that happen to them might fall into one basket called the good things that happened to me in my life, or it might fall into the other basket that's called the bad things that happened to me in my life, the things I don't like, the things I don't want, the things that shouldn't have happened. Now, this is the source, this is the beginning of all the conflict that humanity is going to go through later. None of that conflict would have been possible had humanity not changed from thinking in a form of unity, a form of acceptance, of living with what was created originally, into a form of, no, we don't trust him. We don't know if he created right. Let us judge what should have been, and we're going to create what should be because we're smarter. We know what needs to happen. And now everything that happens gets judged. Everything that happens is good or evil, is for you or against you, is helping you or hurting you. And now they're going into a place that has many changes. They left the unity, the tree of unity. That's the highest tree of all trees. The Elohim, the divine nature, as it created man, it created him straight, it created him direct. It didn't want to confuse him. It didn't want to make his life complicated. But what happened afterwards? They made themselves a lot of calculations. They made life very, very complicated for themselves. He made you simple. Accept what is and work with it. Make it better. Make it even better. Make it as good as you want. It's yours. Do with it as you please. They're making a lot of complications. This I like. This I don't like. This should have been this way, and this should have been that way. Why is this here, and why is this there, and why isn't it the other way around? Now, instead of fixing what is, they're fighting with it. Now they're going to have moods. Now life is going to get complicated. Their hearts are turning in accordance with their interpretation. Their hearts are turning pro-life against life, pro-reality against reality, towards God, away from God. Their heart became like a leaf, turning in accordance with their brain to reality and from reality, loving it and hating it. Zimling letav, sometimes it's good. Zimling lebish, sometimes it's bad. Zimling lerachme, sometimes they feel merciful. Zimling ledina, sometimes they're full of judgment. Bahai milad is dabukibo, in these things that they are attaching themselves to, they looked for many, many calculations and complications, and they attached themselves to them. So now every time they're thinking, their thoughts are preparing realities that later is going to become part of their nefesh, part of their experience. So they're attaching themselves to different sides of life, different judgments about life, and then those judgments become moods, those judgments become a nefesh inside of you that feels that way. Where is he coming from? He's coming as a collection of all those moments where you were against life, where you were fighting with life, where you were disappointed with life. All these are collecting themselves in the spirit, and then suddenly he turns against. Now he has off time. He's not functioning. So Amalei Kitche Bricha, Kadosh Baruch Hu says to Adam, Adam, my man, Shevakt Chayev is Dabke the Moise, you left life and you went looking for death. Chayev Dechsiv Etzachayim is Echagan. You had life because it says the tree of life was within the Gan, within the garden. Where's the garden? The garden is the part of the Nefesh that's inside the body. That's called the garden. It has many different things happening in that garden. There's different animals, there's different trees, there's different plants, there's different flowers. Your body has all of that, and it's your garden. It's the place where you can sow, and whatever you sow will turn into big, big things. It will grow, it will become everything that you have. You sow inside your nefesh, inside that part of you that resides within your body. And so that was the tree of life. If he would have kept that, if he would have understood what he received and appreciated it, then he would have been connected to the tree of life. He would have had life. If somebody is attached to that tree, if somebody perceives reality from the appropriate angle, then he never tastes the taste of death. Because death is when something is taken away. Death is a form of disappointment. Death is a form of separation. When we live in a life of acceptance, when we live in a life of unity, then there's no death. Nothing can be taken away from you because you have no expectation. You're not expecting anything so that anything should be available for taking. So you don't feel the taste of death. You, man, went and you look for a different chi. There's for sure going to be death. The feet are going down towards death. For sure, he was looking for the place of death. Veshuvak asar dechai, he left the place of life. Begin kach, izgizar alev akol alma moise. Therefore, he and everybody after him received death. What is death? Bad moods. What does bad moods do? It ruins our entire experience. We can't go too high. because as soon as we go a little high, comes a bad mood and drags us back down. And then we start running up again. And then as soon as we start stabilizing, comes a bad mood and drags us back down. So we can't go too far because we have this changing spirit inside of us that keeps on showing different faces of itself. So because we started interacting with life in an unhealthy way, so now our spirit became that. Now our spirit became that unhealthy relationship with reality. That's what's driving us already from within. So this goes all the way back to the Etz Hadas. The Etz Hadas didn't create big evil spirits like the ones running the world today, but it created already the possibility. It created already an opening. Man was no longer protected. Man no longer knew the truth. Man was no longer attached to his origin. And now things became possible. Now that he has bad moods, A, he's going to want to manipulate, and B, he's going to have weaknesses and we're going to be able to manipulate. And so this is the opening scene to the devastation that humanity has experienced all the way till today. This is the beginning. This is where it starts. This is the reason why anyone in humanity would ever be so vicious, would ever be so cruel to even do these atrocities that were done in history. How can they get there? How could this happen? It happens from this tiny difference in thinking, from this tiny door that was opened, where we said, maybe we know better than the Creator what should be. Maybe we're a little smarter. He's a genius, there's no question, but maybe we still know a little something that he's forgotten. From that maybe, from that door, from that opening, humanity has been rolling down and down and down and further away from reality as they try to control reality. And they've created structures and systems to control each other, and to control nature, and to control reality, and to be able to move around quickly around the globe as if somewhere else they're going to find peace. And they've been running and running and running and running, and nobody's running after them. It's all in their minds. It's all because there's an imbalance in the way that they think. They haven't recognized the experience correctly. So that's the Eitz Hadas. The Eitz Hadas, Tov V'ra, the Eitz that allows you to know good and evil. Life doesn't have good and evil. It's a human invention. Life has easy and difficult. Life has pain and pleasure, but it doesn't have good and evil. You know what the ancient meaning for the word evil is? The ancient meaning for the word evil is the opposite of peace. Everything that disturbs peace is evil. That's the source root of evil. Any evil in the Torah is only called evil because it somehow disturbs human peace. And peace is life. And here human beings lost access to peace. Now they're going to have two spirits fighting with each other within their mind. Yeah, it's a Tov and the Yetzirah, the one that thinks life is good and the one that thinks life is bad. The one that thinks humans are good, the one that thinks humans are bad. They're going to fight with each other. And so we're not going to have peace. But that's why it's called the Yetzirah, the angel of evil. Why evil? Because it takes away the peace. That's why the Torah is called the Rechei Darchei Noyam. Her ways are sweet. All her lanes lead to peace. Meaning, every single mitzvah of the 630 mitzvahs, why was it given to you? To help you achieve peace. That's the goal. That's why Babichis Kahanim. That's the bracha. V'yosem l'cha shalom, you should give you peace. Every Shemoneh Esrei, the last bracha. Sim shalom toiv v'bracha, place peace, goodness, and blessing. Chaim, chaim, v'chesed, v'rachamim. These are all the same thing. All coming from peace. With peace comes blessing, good, life, grace, kindness, mercy. All of them come from shalom, from peace. And here, man lost his peace. Man lost his ability to think straight because he with himself are arguing about it. So as much as he look outside, he's never going to be at peace. He's never going to be at peace inside. So that's the beginning. So says the Zohar, because he left the place of life, he got a gzeir of death. So he says, "Ihi chote kol ha'am ma'chati." Okay, Adam Rishon did something wrong. He got punished. But why does the whole world have to suffer? All the animals, all the trees, everything was degraded. If you want to say that all the animals ate from the tree of knowledge, that's not the case. When a man stood on his feet, all the creatures of the world saw him, and they were afraid of him. Every animal in the world was afraid of man. A man stood in front of a lion, the lion would kneel to the king. They would go and cater to him like servants to a king. What would he say to these animals? Anu va'atin, let me and you, boy nishtachave v'nichro, nivrcho lefnei Hashem Oseinu. Let's go and bow down and be humble to the one who created us, to recognize his glory, to recognize the wisdom. And all the animals would go after him. So everybody was in their right energy, everybody was in their right state when man was in his right state. As soon as they saw that man bowed down to this place of judgment and started judging the world, all the animals, now their state of mind changed. Now they became judgment. Now they became forceful with each other. Now those who had it within their nature suddenly started eating others, because man had a streak of violence and now the animals had a streak of violence. Everything got dragged along with him. He brought death upon the whole world. Man changed to many colors. Zimnin dina, zimnin rachme. Sometimes he is judgment, and sometimes he is mercy. Zimnin moise, zimnin chai. Sometimes he is death, and sometimes he is life. He could never stand firmly in one state, in one mood. Begin that he has sargorim, like the place that he stands, the way that he interacts, the way that he sees life, is causing him that he shouldn't have access to a continuous life. He has access to an unstable life, a life that goes and comes, a life that's constantly up and down and all around, and it doesn't have peace. It doesn't have stability. That's why it's called the sword that turns over. It's turning over from this side to the other side. Mitav lebish, from good to bad. Mirachme ledina, from mercy to judgment. Mishlam lekrova, from peace to conflict. Misapechasi bekoyle tovera, it's constantly turning over and over, this way and the other way. Dechsiv ve'etz adas tovera, we're talking about the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Imalki lo, the king above, meaning the deeper intelligence of man, the intelligence that belongs to the collective, to the original man, he's one shtik rachamim, he's one shtik mercy. So la rachma levodai, because he had mercy on man, oichachlei, he directed him, ve'omalei, and he told him, imeitzadas tovero, sechlo mani, don't do it, don't go there. Don't interact with life in that way, because it's going to make your life difficult. You want to be a wise guy, you want to start choosing what's going to happen to you, you want to start controlling the future. You're not going to have control, and you're going to suffer. Don't do it. Who like kibul minei, he didn't accept. He got dragged after his wife, and he went into exile for eternity until Mashiach comes. This is the place that a woman understands. This is a place that's related more to the emotional self. Through the woman came that a man got also dragged into thinking in this way. Come and see what's going to happen on with us in the world to come. Sif, ki kimei oetz, kimei ami. Like the days of the tree are the days of my nation. Kimei oetz ahid ishtumedo. Like the tree which is the tree of life, the one that's known. Beizim niksiv, bila amoves lenetzach, imoch Hashem lekim dimim al kol ponim. That when people are going to go back to the tree, when the days of the nation, the days of the people will be like the days of the tree, when they're going to recognize the unity again. On that it says that bila amoves lenetzach, death will be swallowed for eternity. Imoch Hashem lekim dimim al kol ponim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will wipe off the tears from every single face. V'cherpas amo yosir ma'al kol oretz, and they will remove the shame and the embarrassment of his nation from upon the earth. So when people will change how they interact with life, so then they will see life for the first time. People haven't seen life since this story happened 6,000 years ago. Life was never experienced appropriately. Only the prophets had little glimpses of life, little glimpses of what life was supposed to look like. But even they couldn't have access to that life because the collective was not there. The deeper spirit of humanity, the deeper spirit of the world, wasn't yet at the level where he was recognized enough in the world in order to create a stable presence. And this is what's going to happen in the future, that things are going to be very different simply because humanity is going to think differently. That's all. That's all that's necessary. Humanity is going to think differently. It's going to affect the spirit within humanity to feel differently. The spirit within humanity feels differently, then the collective feels differently. The collective feels differently, everything is different. Because that's just nature. That's how it was created. So by us misunderstanding something, maybe a little thing, and at that point in time, it created damage that's continuous. It's getting worse and worse. Like Chazal said, that there's not a day that's not worse than the day before, as long as the Beis HaMikdash is not rebuilt. And that's because the wounds are on top of each other. Yesterday's wounds didn't heal, and today there are more wounds. So now we're even a little further from our core. We're really even a little further from appeasing our spirit, appeasing our source, recognizing life for what it is. And so every day there's an additional burden. There's an additional difficulty. There's an additional distance. And it's upon us. It's in our hands. We have the power as a nation, as a people, to change the course of our lives. And by doing that, we change the course of history, we change the course of humanity, we change the course of the entire history that's been taking place for the last 6,000 years. This has been the struggle. The wars, all the wars that we've seen, all the wars that the world has seen, all of them are the struggle of this tree, the struggle of good and evil, the struggle of what is the destiny of humanity? What are we supposed to be doing here? How are we going to find peace over here? So this struggle, we are members of. We are within the army, one army or the other army, maybe in the good army, hopefully, and we can help humanity heal. We can help people realize the unity, realize source, realize that we were given everything we have without any conditions, and we have to receive everything we have without any conditions before we can see life for what it really is. So we should all be zoicher that we should have the healing that we need so that we can go back to that unity, so we can realize the truth, and be zoicher to the Gula Shleimah.